as much as you can in your backyard. Go and find it!
We'll head around to all the towns. Head away, holiday. South Aussie with Cozzy's on Sit Down. South Aussie with Cozzy. In South Australia we will go. Head away, holiday. South Australia all the way. South Aussie with Cozzy.
G'day, my name's Cozzy. Welcome to another episode of South Aussie with Cozzy. You know, I was born in Murray Bridge. I grew up on York Peninsula in Kadena. I went to Roseworthy College, and now I find myself hosting a TV show all about South Australia, and I love it. And I'll tell you why. I think more South Australians should be spending time with loved ones, and where better place to do it than the regions of South Australia? Because that pumps money back into our own economy, and that creates jobs. We're here in Lake Gairdner. This is at the top of Eyre Peninsula, a region I just don't get to nearly enough. It is divine. Lake Gairdner itself, well, it's a salt lake that is bigger than Kangaroo Island. But first up, let's see what's on the show. OMG, hashtag to die for, I'll show you Bungaree Station, which is just north of Clare. I loved it. And whilst in Clare, we'll explore Shut the Gate Winery. But first up, are you sick of South Aussie kids spending too much time inside? Me too. Well, we're going to sort it out. It's off to Bellaire National Park. You know, it's been suggested that the average Australian child spends, believe it or not, less time outdoors than a maximum security prisoner. Can you even believe that that statistic exists? So the good news is, from a South Australian point of view, is that there's a group that is trying to do something about that. The group's called Nature Play SA, and they're all about doing what I'm doing now, just getting out and enjoying the environment that we have here in South Australia, and that I love. Come on, duck.
There's a figure at the moment that the South Australian children are spending an average of 4.5 hours a day in front of the screen. As a mum, that is not very healthy, and also as a teacher, I'm seeing it, and also seeing children are not out there, and it's affecting them as a whole. Nature Play SA is a new organisation that has just been formed. It's a government initiative, and it's about getting children back outdoors and interacting with nature again. We're trying to educate parents to make time in their schedules to let their children have the opportunity of going to these amazing parks. We're also creating resources for teachers. We're also going to be a central hub where everyone can come to us to get information about Nature Play. At Bellaire National Park, this is a great nature play experience for families. There's a lot to offer here, from the animals, to the parks, to the trees, to the whole range of experience of nature play activities.
I wonder if these girls are thinking what I'm thinking. Why on earth did this koala choose to lay in the ants? The whole Bellaire area, including this national park, I'm addicted to. It is so cool and great for the family. But you know, South Australians have been coming here for generations. How's this mob of party people from 1909? And there's lots of physical activity that's gone on over that time. Of course, back then, strict dress codes applied, which means you could go running in races if you wanted, but you had to dress like this. But it hasn't always been fun and games like this. There has been tragedy here in Bellaire, including a massive train crash. Two trains loaded with passengers had a head-on crash here in Bellaire in 1951. Luckily for everyone, no one was killed, and the cleanup teams had this whole mess sorted out within 24 hours. Man, imagine being on that train. Now that is freaky. All right, I'm gonna show these guys something that you can do with the kids or just by yourself that is totally free to do, and a great spot to do it is here in Bellaire. Okay, these turkeys here are from Roma Mitchell Secondary College out at Jeff's Cross. Now, we're talking about you guys spending time outside. How much time a day are you spending outside?
Hardly an hour.
Hardly anything? What are you doing? What are you doing instead? You're inside doing what?
Social media.
Did you know that like Australian kids spend less time outdoors than a maximum security prisoner in Australia?
Nope.
Wow.
You gotta get outside more. Okay, so I wanna show you some cool things you can do, all right? So like, firstly, how good is that gum tree behind us? Like, look at the feature, look at the gnarliness of that trunk on that tree. That thing's probably over 100 years old. That's pretty crazy, hey? Yeah. Unless you look for these things, you can't find them. This is the other thing. Okay, I love this. Does anyone know what these are?
No idea.
You don't know what these are?
I've seen them.
Oh, I'll give you a massive clue. They're gum nuts. Okay. That's actually the answer.
That is a clue.
You don't eat them. No. So what you do with these, right, is you collect them off the ground and then you grow your own gum tree. Put them in a paper bag. As they'll dry out, these things drop all little seeds. So they'll drop all the seeds out. Put the seeds in the ground and grow your own gum tree. And in 100 years, yours might look like that. Now that is cool, and it's outside. The downside is you'll all be dead by then. But thinking what your kids can enjoy.
True. As a person, I mean, and my children, it makes you happy being outdoors. It's great for their gross motor skills. They're jumping over logs. They're climbing. It's good for their sensory vision as well, with touching and that. And anyone who goes outside, you feel good. And it's healthy. It's a healthy lifestyle. We have created some great resources. We have resources for 51 things to do before you're 12. You can download them on our website. These are really easy, simple, cheap things to do to get the kids outside, and also a great resource for the parents to know what to do.
But what about if I said, as a parent, you know, you gotta be careful with your kids nowadays?
No. And that's something I really, really want to send a message to parents. It's all right for our children to climb a tree, to catch a wave, to walk to the park by themselves. We have to let go, because we are living in a really, really risk-averse society. And that's also one of my challenges, is to let them experience what we experienced as children. I'm actually a bit sad that I have this role and that there's a need for this role. And as a community, we really can make a difference. We're a very small organisation. I can't do it by myself. Everyone needs to come on the journey with me.
Okay, so I'm encouraging you guys to get outside more, which you're going to do from now, right? Yeah?
Yeah.
And that's what Nature Plays SA is all about. So when it comes to social media, which you've all said you're addicted to, let me borrow your phone for a minute. I'm saying, let it go, let it go, let it go and get outside. That was a Frozen reference from the hit Disney movie. Did you get that one?
Yeah.
Okay. Have your phone back. Ooh, you're almost out of battery. South Aussie with Cosy. South Aussie with Cosy. Welcome, my friends, to the Clare Valley, which is the perfect location for a romantic getaway and a wine.
Shut the Gate Wines in the middle of Watervale, Clare Valley. We're a relatively new winery for the Clare Valley. We specialise in local Rieslings in particular, something we do very well in Clare. We also do Shiraz and some alternative varieties. Small batch winemaking, that's what we like to do. Little batches between 200 and 500 dozen. We're pretty casual here. One of the things that we really like to work on is demystifying wine. So my wife and I and our casual staff really like to work to make sure that customers feel relaxed and at home, and we're talking in, you know, wine language that's not going to alienate them.
They've also got what could possibly be the world's most relaxed cat. Yep, Clare Valley will do it to you.
We offer a free tasting 7 days a week. We're open from 10 to 4:30 every day. We have a small Providor store that specialises in local handmade, crafted produce.
This is the way the Providor room works here. I see you've got your baskets already, and then you just go around and look on the shelves and see all the little exciting bits and pieces that we have. And we've collected foods from all over South Australia, some local produce. We have all sorts of relishes. We have the very, very best salted walnuts you're ever going to eat. A local called Rex from Seven Hill, he brines them overnight, dries them in the oven after that, and so it's not salty on the outside, it's just really yummy and crunchy with a little bit of salt. So you're going to have to put that in your basket, I reckon, for sure. But then you really need to go over to the fridge, because the fridge has cheeses from all over South Australia. We have San Jose Small Goods, a really good producer from South Australia that only uses female Berkshire free-range pigs. So there's prosciutto, there's chorizos, and lots of other things. Pop over there. When you're ready, give me the basket, I'll warm up some bread, and I'll bring it outside to you. Yeah.
Clare Valley is a very special place. It's one of those remaining agricultural wine areas that still has a lot of soul. We're a genuine community that really does care about making sure that people looked after when they visit, families, children we encourage. It's a little hideaway. We think it's the best kept secret in the wine industry. So it's a great place to escape. It's only an hour and a half north of Adelaide. So it's not as far as some people like to think it is.
That one's my favourite out of everything.
It's one of those areas that you can really forget about the TV, the iPad, the kids being buried in an iPhone. It's a great place that they can actually get out and get closer to nature. So you can see livestock, farming practices, you can see the beautiful crops in flowering spring, you can see the spring lambs, so the kids can get out and see, you know, genuine Australian rural lifestyle. The Cellar Door tasting area is housed in an 1840s cottage by a little creek with its own well out the back. That cottage has seen many, many generations of locals born, conceived, married, and passing away in those walls. So the place is a living, breathing museum of humanity, and we just love to entertain. And it's a Cornish cottage, so you got to watch your head when you're walking around.
Clare Valley is filled with wineries, and best of all, it costs nothing to visit. Choose from a few favourites and go and say g'day. Do you deserve a free holiday? Of course you do. Then you better like the South Aussie with Cozzy Facebook page because we've got 10 to give away, including a stay up in the Adelaide Hills at the Divine House Studio Apartments located in Harndorf. Forget the hills as a day trip. Come and stay and come and play. That's what the house is all about. The studio apartments are located only 50 metres from the main street of Harndorf. You could be enjoying a free night in an apartment plus a cooked breakfast across the road at the house cafe, bar and kitchen. They don't just do the best brekkie in the hills, they've also got the largest selection of German beers as well. Al fresco dining in summer or fireside in winter, you're going to enjoy it year round at the house. Just like the South Aussie with Cozzy Facebook page and enter. There's plenty more South Aussie with Cozzy coming up after the break. That could have ended poorly.
South Aussie with Cozzy. South Aussie with Cozzy.
Our mighty South Aussie this week is Queen of the News and a passionate South Australian girl. It is Kate Collins.
I love SA because we really do have it all here. We've got world-class wine, we've got great food, and we've got the hills, the beach, and also the desert. And to top it off, the people are really friendly. The last place that we visited was Fisherman's Bay. It's down near Port Broughton, and friends of ours have a place down there, and the boys always go fishing. But I love the fact that you can stay in one of those little tiny fisherman shacks and just feel like you're a world away. Well, I'm a real sucker for a wine tour, so I love jumping on a bus with a group of friends and going around and tasting a few of the wines in the area and then stopping somewhere lovely and picturesque for lunch.
If you listen to one thing I say this episode, then listen to this. Clare Valley is closer to Adelaide than you actually think it is.
There's a place just north of Clare called Bungaree Station, and I honestly have wanted to visit this place since I was about 5 or 6 years old. Mum and Dad never took me. But finally, I've got my own travel show and I get to have a bit of a sticky beak. Let's go.
This girl, she's begging you go away. Hiding from you, the smudge is on her face. Tell me why she keeps it to herself.
Bungaree Station was founded by my wife's great-great-grandfather, George Charles Hawker, in 1841 with his two brothers, James and Charles. They came up from Adelaide with 2,000 sheep and settled here on Christmas Day, 1841. They settled here because of the good rainfall, the good soil, and also there were no other white settlers here at that point in time. And then in 1842, they started building the wool shed, and it was from there they started sheep farming, so that by the 1880s, they were farming about 100,000 sheep here, spread over 237 square miles. We've got all the associated buildings here on the property, the wool shed, the shearers' quarters, church, council chambers. And as a result, with a modern farm these days, you don't use all those buildings anymore. So all the buildings were converted back 30 years ago by my wife's mother, Sally, and she started the tourism business then. We can sleep 40 people on the property, and we have a lot of functions here, like the one we've got here this weekend, the Hats function.
Oh, a lot of luck and tigers, it's plain to see we are up to our pearly ringer as we now call the tar. Ah, here calls one quick, the tar boy flies, eh?
We're Hats, and we're an incorporated, not-for-profit arts cultural organisation. We're based in the Clare Valley. And this is our weekend that we come to Bungaree Station, and Hats stands for Heritage, Arts and Traditions. So we like to keep the traditions of the Australian living traditions alive, and Bungaree is just the perfect place to do this.
We get a lot of weddings up here, probably a good dozen every year. They have the wedding up in the gardens, and then they have the reception down here in the wool shed. So the wool shed's the oldest building on the property. They started building that in 1842, and the size of it just grew and grew and grew to accommodate the more sheep that they had. And so you can imagine 100,000 sheep, you need 50 odd shearers, and that's with blade shears, not with mechanical shears. So more sheep, more shearers, and the shed just grew to the size that you see today when it was finished being built in 1880. So if you can picture it being built 4 years after South Australia was settled, the first foundation stones were being laid for this building here.
How's this? Elders Pastoral Company, well, the first cheque that they ever wrote out for a bale of wool was written out to Bungaree Station, just north of Clare. Coming up, I'll take you through the accommodation options these guys have, including a place honeymooners stay that's called the Stallion Box. Hello, sailor.
Somehow see we're causing.
Clare Valley is nothing short of outstanding. It's all about falling off the map and falling in love with the Clare Valley and your partner. It's the perfect spot for a romantic getaway, or if the babysitter falls through like it did for us, thanks Grandma, hey, why not bring the kids? We're having a look around Bungaree Station just north of Clare, where they've got loads of accommodation options.
We can comfortably accommodate 70 people in a function over in the shearers' quarters, and here in the wool shed we can accommodate seated about 150 people. So it's an ideal location for any birthday functions or for weddings as well.
Don't hold that pin so close, so close to the
One of the main attractions to Bungaree Station is the fact that it's still a working property. We still farm sheep here and we still crop. As a result, every year we get those pet lambs that we've got to feed and the potty calves as well. And also we've got some pet deer. So it's a great place to bring your kids to feed the animals.
You've got to have your head flat, otherwise they'll bite.
Behind me here is the Stallion Box. It gets that name because originally the working stallion on the property was based here, and all his mares were over that way. These days, like all the other buildings on the property, it's been converted into tourism, and this is probably the cheaper option of the buildings because it's the smallest. It's just a little ensuite for a queen-size bedroom, and it proves to be very popular with the honeymooners we get here with their weddings. Behind me here are two other accommodation options that we've got. We've got the old council chambers, which was built in 1868 for the Hill and Hutt River Council, and it was also a school as well. This house, it's got two bedrooms, twin ensuited, and it's got a self-contained kitchen like all the other houses on the property. And then to my left here, we've got the manager's house. As the name would suggest, it's where the manager for the property lived, and it's probably one of the bigger houses that we've got here.
They also have a historic walking trail around the property, and they give you a map when you check in. Best of all, it's totally free, and there's speaker boxes that relay the station's history.
The manager at Bungaree resided on the property with their family.
have a look at some of the photos I took up at Bungaree Station. Oh man, they made for awesome Facebook posts, but more importantly, I reckon this is the best family time I've had in the last 6 months. My wife and I spent the whole trip back to Adelaide discussing when could we possibly book another trip to Bungaree Station. My photos aside, it's actually your photos that I want to see. Sharon sent me her photos from the annual Lake Bonnie bonfire held at the Discovery Holiday Park in Barmera. The CFS run the bonfire and it's raised 10 grand over the years, and best of all, it's totally free to go to if you're staying at the park, and it's right alongside the lake as well. Now, one lucky viewer is going to win $200 cash, all thanks to Adelaide Arcade, so keep sending me in your happy snaps. Well, that's it for another episode of South Aussie with Cozzy. We're going to finish right here in the Rundle Mall. You know, the mall's been going through some massive renovations in the last 12 months. And do you know how much money they've spent on this place?
$25 million.
$25 million. In fact, as far as I'm concerned, this whole area, we've got the brand new Adelaide Oval.
Victoria Square's looking awesome.
It is. And we've got the whole feeling of the city coming to life. Well, that's all we've got time for, folks. We'll catch you next week. And don't forget, like the South Aussie with Cozzy Facebook page. Have you guys done that yet?
Yeah.
Yes, yes. Half of them are probably lying. But you can win 10 free holidays in South Australia. We'll see you next week.
In South Australia, we will go head away, holiday. South Australia all the way, South Aussie with Cozzy.
South Aussie with Cozzy is proudly brought to you by the South Australian Tourism Commission.
South Aussie with Cozzy.
I like pushups.